It's Halloween today, and Over the Garden Wall is the perfect cartoon to talk about. I decided, since college has been zapping practically all of my free time recently, that I'll hold off on a review of this series and instead do a top 5 darkest video on it, since that's a lot easier for me to make and I could actually get it out in time for Halloween. So, without further ado, grab your candy. And let's jump into the top 5 darkest moments from Over the Garden Wall. And number 5 is an iconic moment. The Beast is revealed. For pretty much the whole series, the Beast remains in the shadows. Only his outline and eyes are visible. However, in the last episode, we do, for a very brief moment, see what he truly looks like. When the woodsman flashes the lantern towards the beast, his true form is revealed, and boy does it look disturbing. He appears to be made out of the distorted faces of the souls that he has claimed over the years in the unknown. This is some pretty messed up imagery from a show that aired on Cartoon Network, and yet that is still barely able to make it on this list. Proving that Over the Garden Wall is one of the darkest series that Cartoon Network ever picked up. For number 4, we have the first encounter with the Pumpkin People of Pottsfield. What makes this scene so creepy is the fact that it starts out lighthearted and fun, and there's seemingly no danger before this happens.
Oh, are we leaving already?
Let's leave immediately.
I'm just trying to get home.
I'm supposed to be here. Maybe he's here to steal our crops,
to ruin our party,
or take off our pumpkin shoes.
Now hold on, everybody. Let's not jump to any conclusions.
The sheer creepiness of all of these eyeless pumpkin people staring at Wart, Greg, and Beatrice is something that sends chills down to my spine. But then it gets worse. Enoch, the giant pumpkin, moves in and speaks to the group in a harsh whisper. This, combined with all the soulless pumpkin people staring at the trio, just makes the whole tone of this scene very creepy, and definitely is one of the more memorable sequences, at least for me, in Over the Garden Wall. Number 3 is maybe the most graphic scene from the series. I am talking about Adelaide's death scene in episode 6. After Wart discovers that Beatrice was originally going to turn him and Greg over to Adelaide to be slaves, Adelaide captures them and is going to cut out their brains and replace them with wool. That's already pretty dark in of itself. But it becomes even darker when Beatrice, to save Wart and Greg, opens the window and lets the nighttime air in, which is poisonous to Adelaide, causing her to disintegrate into dust before our eyes. Add some pretty graphic imagery for a PG cartoon, and you get yourself one disturbing death scene and the number 3 spot on my list. In second place comes perhaps the scariest episode from Over the Garden Wall. And yes, I said episode because there are so many dark and scary scenes from this episode that I couldn't just pick one. The episode I'm referring to is The Ringing of the Bell, the 7th episode in the series. Let me quickly go over everything that makes this episode so dark. First off, the premise is Wart and Greg hiding from a hideous humanoid creature named Auntie Whispers, who wants to eat them. Secondly, she has this girl named Lorna, who she forces with mind control to do chores all day in an endless cycle of depression. Also, one of those chores is to arrange the bones of the children she has slaughtered and eaten. Who the heck thought this episode was a good idea to air on Cartoon Network? Seriously, that's some very dark subject matter. And that's not even implied, she just straight up casually mentions it. Although that was probably the darkest moment from this episode, the scariest one comes near the end. And it goes a little something like this.
What is she talking about?
I told you boys to stay away from her, but now you've gone and made her with you again.
On a scale of 1 to 10, this demon-possessed girl is a 10, and in my opinion, is the scariest thing we see from over the garden wall. I legitimately was wondering how they were allowed to get away with such shocking imagery, but ultimately, this scary scene made this episode one of the most memorable for me, and earns its spot at number 2. Now, I know what you're thinking. What could be even darker than that? Well, allow me to present you with the absolute darkest moment from Over the Garden Wall. And it's actually kind of two moments. They're both from episode 10, The Unknown. And the first one is when the beast reveals to the woodsman that all the Edelwood trees the woodsman has cut down to fuel the lantern have actually been the souls of the lost children the beast has claimed. So yeah, this whole time, the woodsman has been unknowingly killing perhaps hundreds of children to keep the lantern with his daughter's soul in it lit. How is something like this even allowed on Cartoon Network? My dude just found out he has been murdering children for years. This is easily the darkest moment from Over the Garden Wall, but I'm also including a moment that happens just a few minutes later. When Wart leaves the lantern with the woodsman and rejects the beast's offer, the beast reminds him that the lantern still needs oil and that those who die in the woods turn into Edelwood trees. Then the beast tells the woodsman to chase Greg and Wart and kill them with his axe to turn them into trees and keep the lantern lit. Excuse me? Before, it was just the souls of children, so maybe that's passable. But now, the beast beckons the woodsman to literally chop up two innocent children into pieces. Yeah, these two moments combined to form the absolute darkest moment from Over the Garden Wall. I think it's clear to see that this show was easily one of the darkest cartoons that has ever aired on Cartoon Network, and it was honestly the perfect cartoon to talk about on Halloween. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and be sure to leave a like if you did. Really quick update about my channel. Sorry for not posting videos regularly like I used to. College has been really busy these past 2 weeks, leaving me with hardly any free time at all. On top of that, I had this really big project for the channel that I've been working on, and I was trying to release it on Halloween, but unless some miracle happens, it probably won't be out until November. So stay tuned for that, and thank you guys for being patient. I'm also kind of running thin on ideas for videos, so I would appreciate any suggestions in the comments below, and if it lines up with something that's like within my video making ability, then I'll definitely be considering it. Anyways, have a great Halloween, guys, and I'll see you all on the next one. Have a great day.